And now he's saying that he's going to veto it. There is some nuance to it with him saying that he wants a larger size payment to the American people, which is something that Democrats argue for at every step of the process. And now House Democrats say, OK, well, if that's what he wants, we'll provide him with that. I wonder just what you make of this very last minute scramble of what we thought was going to proceed here with this relief bill.
I kept thinking tonight, well, these pardons are an attack on our very democracy. This is an attack on every American, people who are struggling to get by right now, out of work, whose unemployment, the unemployment is going to basically end the day after Christmas if this doesn't pass. People who are out of work, people who need the help. The vaccine distribution, Rachel, is in this $30 billion. These vaccines are not going to just parachute into a small town in the middle of Minnesota. We need the help for the states to get the vaccines out. And he is literally undermining our entire effort on testing and vaccine distribution. This was a hard-fought negotiation. Of course, you're right. Democrats were pushing for more funds for the individual payments. But in the end, this was a negotiation. And he knows very well we're reaching the end here with the unemployment, with our small businesses can't take it anymore. One Yelp study early in the year showed we were having 800 small businesses close a day. And there's over $300 billion to help small businesses in this bill. It is the second biggest stimulus in the history of America. And for him to turn this down, obviously we have the votes to override his veto in the houses. We have those votes. But he should not be doing this right now when his own Treasury Secretary, Steve Mnuchin, was involved in the negotiations from beginning to end. He is literally trying to burn this country down on his way out, as I said at the beginning. And all we can do is push and make it very clear as we go into these Senate races in Georgia, Rachel, which party has people's back and which party is in the White House.